Welcome back to my channel. I'm trying to do like a weekly vlog of me going to work because this week I work Tuesday to Friday. And if you guys follow me on TikTok, then you will know that I am a mother baby nursing assistant, also known as like the postpartum four. So I really want to, I already make like mini vlogs on TikTok, but I just decided why not make a whole week vlog on YouTube for you guys to see. And I also answer some of the questions that I've been getting asked a lot on TikTok, like throughout this video. So I've dressed, I need gas, so it's supposed to be my first stop. I have to be to work at 3:30. It's 2:07, so I have a little bit over an hour to go. The gas station is right down the street. So I'm gonna head to the gas station, get some gas, and then off to work. But it looks weird. I think that's how you do it. I read in the comments that you have to hang it upside down and then rotate the footage later. So hopefully that's right. Oh my god, my hair is a mess. I might do it tomorrow. But I just got to work, and honestly, it's really hard to find parking spots at the beginning of the week because like I had to circle around this parking lot like 5 times before I found this spot. And that's so irritating. But like on a Friday or Saturday, I can pull right in up at the front and walk right into work. But at the beginning of the week, it's pretty hard because I think like everybody works at the beginning of the week.
Okay, I just made it into work and I did stop at Starbucks, but I didn't get the ice white mocha. I got the chestnut praline latte instead because it started snowing outside and I didn't want to be cold, honestly. So here goes my drink. I love the little Christmas cups. And I did get my butter croissant. My shift starts at 3:30. It is 3:08. I used to get here a little early just so I can enjoy my Starbucks for a bit and see how many patients I'm gonna have for a day. My shift goes until 12 o'clock, which isn't too bad because around like 9, 10 o'clock, I pretty much be done with everything. Really about like 8. It just depends on how many patients are here for today. What else? I haven't checked the board, so I'm not too sure on how today is about to go. Fingers crossed. It's not crazy, but usually Mondays is like the busier days because that's when like a lot of scheduled C-sections are and stuff like that. So we will see, and I'm just going to bring you guys along my day and show you guys everything that I do at work. It is 4:45. I just finished my 4 o'clock vitals of doing mom pool set and baby temperature. So now I have 3 hearing screen tests to do. One of the babies referred from day shift, so I have to redo it on my shift, and then I have 2 of my own. And one of the patients is ready to go home, so I'm about to set up for her baby hearing test. But her baby is getting PKU and CCHD done, so I'm just gonna wait until they finish. But I only have 9 patients today, so I kinda finish vitals a little fast. Sometimes when it's full, it takes me a little while because patients are like, can you grab this, can you grab that? I don't mind, but today, nobody really asked for anything, so I kind of finished a little fast. I'm like, dang, But this is how you set up for a hearing test. You get these little sticky majiggies, and these are the earpieces, and then you hook it on. Then it's like you do green, yellow, black. Green is for the middle of the shoulder blades. Black is for the middle of the forehead. And after I say yellow, I mean white. White goes on the baby neck. And then you hook it up to the machine, and then the machine will let you know if they placed on properly or you need to fix something. So this is how it looks when it's on, little thingy. Sorry, that's my work phone. Blue is for left ear, red is for right ear. And these have to be placed on right or the hearing test will not do right. And just hook it up to the machine, press start, and it'll do everything. It'll let you know if baby passed or baby referred. And for us, if baby refers, we have to pass it on to the next shift, and the next shift will do it when they have time to. Well, however they do it, I don't know. I do mine, like if a baby referred on a shift before me, I do the hearing test that I need to, I do my hearing test, so like baby that's in my shift, and then I do that baby just to give the baby a little more time. So that's about it. I think that's all I have to do today. I already did my vitals. Let's see, I did my vitals. I'm about to do my hearing test. Oh, and one of my patients has a catheter because she had a section, so I have to remove out her catheter, but that doesn't take nothing to do at all. Literally like 15 minutes if that. Just depends on how the patient moves. But that's my day, honestly. I usually take my lunch at like 8 o'clock, because that's when that's my dinner. So that's kind of when I like to eat dinner and stuff. So, and it's only supposed to be 5 o'clock, and I'm going to be done with hearing screens before 6 o'clock. So I'm going to have to find something to do. My job, there are two halls, well, technically three. It's a west hall, then we have north and south. We count north and south as one hall because north side only has like four rooms. So it's like a small little hall, and then south is long. So each week we rotate which hall you get. Like you don't stay on one hall every week, like you just rotate. So this week I have north and south, which means I'm responsible for taking down the circumcision boxes. It's just like a, the red box you take down after the doctors do the baby circumcision. And then you also have to set up for the circs, and you have to clean off the dirty circ boards. So you have north and south, you're responsible for that. What else am I responsible for when I have north and south? Just circ sex. But I think that's it. So when you don't have north to south and you got west, you don't have to say down six sets unless like, you know, co-worker needs help or something. Cause north and south do get super busy. So like when I was west last week, I offered my co-worker like, I'll take down the six sets for you, because that's just a little something she can knock off her list, cause she was really busy. So I think that's it all I can think of right now that I want to talk about. I'm gonna go read my TikTok comments to see what I can answer on here that I didn't answer on TikTok, because on TikTok I get a lot of comments about my job. Excuse me. And if you don't follow me on TikTok, go follow me. It's therealLaLa with two A's on the end, because I post a lot of mini vlogs of me at work, and the girls eat that up. They love it, and I love making them. So follow me on TikTok, subscribe to me on here, and that's all I gotta say right now. See y'all in a bit. Okay, it is 6:28. I just finished all my hearing tests. I had three, and I swear, I think these babies be wanting you to learn how to like save a life, because the one I just got in here, baby was good. Walking the baby down, as soon as I pull the baby in here, start connecting the stuff. She literally started choking. I'm like, oh my God. So I just instantly picked her up, flipped her over, and then started patting her. A lot of times the baby be like throwing up and choking because the parents aren't burping them properly. Like, I've seen some parents tap the baby like this, but sometimes you gotta put a little force in it after feeding to like burp the baby because them little taps not doing anything. But baby was okay, but that's what took me so long to finish because I have to say, future PA here. But I'm finished with the machine, so I always wipe it down after. Just because, you know, safety. Safety, clean, all that. I just take the cords and literally just like wipe it. I had to get some hand sanitizer, but I could chill until about 7:15, 7:30-ish to do my Q4 vitals. I'll probably get some admits soon. I haven't looked at the board to see if we had any new deliveries or if any mothers are dilated or if anybody's in the OR. And when patients are in the OR, I might say that a lot this week, that means that they're having a C-section. And when they're dilated, of course, they're having a batch delivery. And usually when they have a batch delivery, say if somebody deliver at 7, they'll be up by like 8:30-ish, 9. If they do a C-section in the OR at 7, they won't be up until like 10-ish. It usually takes a little bit more time for them to recover after that, then they bring them up. Like, they don't just bring them up straight after. Because that's like a real surgery, so I'll be having more time to get ready for my C-section patients than my badge. Sometimes badge come right up and they be good. But yeah, so I want to chill for a little bit and do some charting. So usually when I take like my little in-between breaks, everybody always know I'm in a corner in the nursery. This is my favorite spot. Like, I got me a little rocking chair, put in my headphones for about, I don't know, however long, and then get up and go back to work. Uh-oh, let's see. Getting the vag delivery, but that is not my hallway. She texts the wrong person. They always get confused on what hallway I got. I don't know why. I don't know. I think I'm about to watch some TikToks real quick. So, right now I'm going to the basement to get an iso. Well, we have an isolation cart. I need some more isolation gowns because one of the patients has COVID and we ran out of gowns. Well, two of the patients do.
Basement.
And we ran out of gowns, so I am in the basement to get my car. So I got the gowns. It's so hard to like record everything I do because I want to keep stuff like confidential. And I don't want nobody to like know what I'm doing and everything. Like, you know. So two bags of gowns should do. Because more than likely, I think my patients are going home today after tomorrow or tomorrow. So that'd be good. Okay, so I just finished eating my lunch and I had some pasta. I was gonna record me eating, but I was hungry. I had some shrimp pasta with broccoli. It was real good. It is 8:40. I started my lunch at 8, so I got about 20 minutes. So far the day has been okay. I haven't had any admissions, which is really shocking. It might be something like, I know it's gonna be something like right before I leave. So that's about it. Today's been a really good day, honestly. I don't have anything left to do. I have something to chart, that's it. But other than that, I don't have anything to do for the rest of the day. I might try to find something to do because I don't know what I'm gonna do from 9 to 11:30. Because technically we're done working at 11:30 because the other shift come in and then we get report. And then I just be sitting here waiting to clock out at 12, so. I don't know, this is my water. I get the water out of our machine with some ice, it's so good. But yeah. Just got off work, it is 12:06. It's cold.
It's nice to meet you, I know you.
today wasn't that bad of a day, honestly. Like, I didn't really get to show y'all much because I didn't have a busy day. So maybe tomorrow I could show a little bit more if I have more to do. I always forget to start my car up when I'm walking over here. But at least it's not that cold tonight though. Ooh, my hair look crazy, but I'm about to head home, shower, and go to bed. I'll probably edit one of my other videos that I did. I did an Indian full review, so I'm gonna edit that. Cause I could post that tomorrow. Might do a little bit of that, and then that's about it, honestly. I was trying to pull off, but I need to fix my heat first. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Today was 1 out of 4, so I'll have 3 more days. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, off for the week. Hey guys, today is day 2 for me of the work week. Dressed, ready to go. I was actually gonna do like a whole little morning thing, show you guys what I eat for breakfast and everything, but I woke up and my day just started off rocky. Like, I got a message saying my Instacart order was canceled, so that made me mad, and it just was like, so I went back to sleep, and then I just got up and got ready for work. I did eat, but I just wasn't in the mood to vlog this morning because, like, Instacart made me so mad. The lady gonna say she couldn't find my home address. Like, I order from Instacart all the time. I ain't never have nobody tell me they can't find a house. So that was that. I had to like get myself together, and then that's when I recorded me getting ready for work or whatever with just the uniform and stuff. So maybe tomorrow we can retry this. But about to head to work right now. It's 2:10. I left something in the house. I'm about to run back and get that. And we should be on good timing for work today. I don't know if I'm gonna get Starbucks because my drink was nasty
yesterday. Hey guys, today has been so busy. I haven't even been able to record to show you guys what I was doing today. But behind me is our warmer. We have like blankets and virgin cloths and everything in case a patient or the baby needs it. Well, they both are patients. In case the mom or the baby need one. And then this bin right here is what I was referring to. The buyer has a bin once a circumcision is done on a baby. And this is the room that we do our circumcisions in.
So this is where baby circumcision is done. We set this up for the doctor. And then on this tray, the supplies will be placed. And usually in this room, it's only the nurse and the doctor in here with the baby. And there's never more than one baby allowed in here. Over here is some extra supplies that might be used during a circumcision. Sometimes when baby is crying or something, they may give them some sugar water to calm them down.
Hey guys, it is the end of my shift. It is going on 11:30, end of day 2. It was super busy today, like extremely busy. I'm happy I could like vlog what I could and whatnot. I will definitely get more content in tomorrow and show you guys. I had to call, but I will definitely try to get more content tomorrow. As I said, today was super busy, so it's a little harder to do when it's like I have to do everything super fast and I can't take the time to record myself and just show you guys what I was doing. So that is definitely to come tomorrow, and I'm just gonna close this out and I will drop the roof and let the smoke clear. I got diamonds doing sissy slides in both ears. Dice rolling on the Las Vegas trip tonight. Slip that on and we might miss the fight. Fucking not, I keep the wallet in my shorty bag. You know she wanna mind when she tattoo that ass. I'm a lover boy, she not a toy. Keep it coming, you a rider. I roll myself a day and count my figure shit. Just to step it out, I feel like I'm that nigga shit. I drop 30 on this room, we ain't gon' sleep for shit. If I catch you nodding off, then it's gon' be some shit. Well, you can do what you wanna.
Hey guys, welcome to day 3.
out of 4. This week kind of going by a little fast, even though yesterday was very busy. Like, I'm like, I can't keep up. Even though I did keep up, that's just what I was thinking in my head. But right now, I'm eating my breakfast. I woke up a little earlier to make me something to eat. 2 boiled eggs and some yogurt. And it goes to me. I don't care if y'all don't think it don't go. Because I love to eat it. My auntie tells me, what you making? Girl, boiled eggs and yogurt. But I must eat my breakfast and then get ready for work. I actually have to go to this mandatory restraint class for all nursing staff, like nursing assistant and nurses. Basically, restraints are just used on certain patients, but on my unit, we don't use them. But they just keep still requiring everybody in the hospital to do the class or whatever. So after I do my vitals, I'm gonna do that. And then I'm gonna just bring y'all on my day today. Hoping it's not busy like yesterday. I don't think so. Cause usually when it's busy one day, it can't be the same type of busy the next day because it's already full, if you get what I'm saying. But that's it honestly for right now. Oh, my Instacart groceries came and it gave me a refund, so free groceries. But I'm gonna check in with y'all later.
Hey guys, so it's about an hour into my shift. Things are going really good. It's 3 nursing assistants today, so which means I got the short hallway, only 5 patients. Well, right now 4. I have a mom with twins coming up, so that's why I'm in here. And I got 4 patients going on 5, and I get all the hearing screens. So 5 patients, 5 hearing screens. It's gonna be a really good day. And right now, I just wanna show you guys how we set up our rooms for upcoming moms. So basically, we get the yellow socks, which indicates fall risk. You get the spirometer. We get a cup, and then you put some extra ones in it with some straws. They get some hand sanitizer, toothbrush, and toothpaste. A cylinder, because you have to measure their output from their catheter when you empty it out. And then these 2 objects are what you need when you take out the catheter. Then they get some tissue, a menu, and some wipes to clean yourself up. Get all that good stuff. You then get them a gown, some face towels, and a full body towel. And what I like to do, I kind of like to wrap it up so we can put it in the basin. And so I just get the towel, the nightgown, and then the face cloths, and I just like wrap it up nice and tight like this. And I'm gonna show you guys the finished product. So this is how it looks. You have everything in here, and then you also put this in there, as well as this green pad. And we also give moms this extra bag of pads. And it is a little cleaning bottle, so you have some underwear, some little pads, and then you have the big white pads. So this is a setup for a mom coming up from having a C-section. This is a setup for a mom that just delivered batch. They get everything, but instead they get the blue socks. They don't get a spirometer or any of this, because this is all if they had a catheter. So they don't get any of these items, but everything is the same. And we also give them an extra green pad and extra bag of pads. The reason why we give this extra green pad is sometimes moms will bleed on this, and then we just want them to have an extra one to, you know, have them feeling clean or whatever. So this is just the difference between a C-section setup and a basic bag setup. So this is our cart for just blankets, green pads, gowns for mom, towels, face towels, sheets, just all that good stuff. And then this is a baby cart. So you have baby blankets, birthing cloths, and the baby t-shirts are always in these bags. And then we keep it closed just to keep them clean and everything. So them are the 2 carts. And then over here, we just have everything for baby and mom. So sometimes mom will ask for hot packs, or you will need if you have to do blood sugars or draw blood from baby heel. You get feet warmers. Baby milk is over here. Have some baby diapers, and then these are the extra pads and wipes. Baby nipples, some more baby diapers, sponges, just a whole bunch of everything you will mostly find in here. Everything but medication. Medication is locked up and stored safely. So this is how it looks once we set it up. Cracker, juice, have the water, all that good stuff. And then this is where we put everything goes. And then we have the security tag for the baby. So I finally got a clean, empty baby crib so I could show you guys what goes in the baby crib. So you start off with 10 diapers, wipes, a little hairbrush sponge, some soap, a ball syringe, a pacifier, 4 little t-shirts, 4 birthing cloths, and 4 blankets. So guys, this is how it looks once it is done. We wrap up the blankets, birthing cloths goes in here, diapers, wipes, all that on this side, and then we cover it up with a bag. So after I am done setting up the cribs, I take them downstairs to labor and delivery. Or sometimes when it's super busy, labor and delivery staff will come up and get the cribs there. So, because sometimes we don't even have enough time to take the cribs down. So that's pretty much what we do with the cribs. The housekeeping come and clean out the rooms, clean the crib. I grab it, set it up, and take it downstairs so they have somewhere where the babies can go after delivery. Hey guys, it is Friday and I'm so happy because I'm off for the weekend, so I'm just in a good mood. But it is finally day 4 of the work week and I had to stop at Ulta and Target before coming to work. So I'm gonna show y'all what I got real quick before I go in. I needed some new sponges. I got me a new liner because the one I had was just done for. And I want to try this NYX Butter Gloss. I used to wear it, but I don't remember what color I used to wear. And then I want to try out NARS concealer. So I got the mini one just to see how it is. And if I like it, I'm going to go back and get the big one when it's run out. So that's what I got from Ulta. And then what I got from Target was just basically some little personal products. I just got me some more Tree Hut, the vanilla bean. Smells so good. This with the Method body wash, when I say like, you gonna be smelling like and it's not too like, it's not too much like that sweet vanilla smell, like it's just right, like just smell like you're gonna be clean. And then I got me some shampoo because I need to wash my bundles because I have something to do this weekend, and this was on sale, and Tresemme works good for my bundles. So I got like the Rich and Moisture shampoo and conditioner, and then some other stuff I got is just personal hygiene products. So that's it. I really just needed to, I didn't feel like going in, so I did drive up with Target because I knew if I went in I wasn't gonna be out by the time I needed to go to work. So I just did like a little drive up, got some few things, and that's about it. So I'm about to go into work. Usually Fridays are not too bad, honestly, so I'm not really worried, and if it is, then it just is. But I'm trying to think, should I stop at Starbucks? No, because I don't have time to go in the Starbucks because that line be long at 3 o'clock, so I'm not gonna have time today. I got here a little later than usual. Any other time I would have had time to go in, but
not today. But I'm gonna keep y'all in tune with me for the rest of the day. Show y'all what I'm about to do at work. Probably won't be much today, honestly. Who knows? But just show y'all whatever I haven't showed y'all this week. And make sure, so this week I didn't get to ask y'all questions. I think I said this already, but even if I did, make sure that y'all comment any questions you have about my job. Because I want to answer them in the next work vlog. So make sure you ask any questions that you had, because I'm going to answer them. And I wrote down the questions that I found from TikTok. I'm going to answer them next week as well, because I totally forgot to do that this week. So that's how I'm going to start off next week.
So this is what it looks like once I baby pass the hearing screen. It just say pass. And then this is what it looks like when you have the things on right. And then this will blink if the earmuffs start coming off. Hey guys, I just finished up my vitals and hearing screens. I only had two of them today. But guess who forgot their lunch? So I have to go to the cafeteria and see what's down there. And if it's nothing good, I'm just going DoorDash. But I think I was so focused on going to Ulta and Target, I literally left my lunch on the counter. So hopefully it's something good. If not, I'll DoorDash something. We usually have pizza and I'm craving pizza, so I'm gonna see. So I'm definitely gonna just order some DoorDash. Like, that food didn't even look edible. Like, I wasn't even gonna waste my time by trying to see if it was decent, because I hate wasting my money on food. So DoorDash it is, just ordering me a veggie pizza. And we're just going to keep it at that. Like, that was my first time going down to our cafeteria. And I won't be back. Unless it's special snacks. Because they did have, like, better made chips and candy and stuff. So, but that food, not it. So, I'm waiting on my food to come. So, I'll go on my lunch and eat. So, I'm starving. And that'll be it for the first time of my shift.
The work week is finally over and I look a mess. Like, my hair in a ponytail, but it's okay because I'm doing my hair tomorrow. But work week finally over. I'm about to enjoy my weekend, and honestly I can't complain about this week. Like, it wasn't that bad except that one busy day, but it's the hospital, so what can I say? Like, I really don't mind my job, honestly. Like, my job is actually pretty cool, so it don't even bug me truly when it's busy. So that's about it. I'm about to enjoy my weekend, like I said, and just relax. I will be making a weekend vlog, so make sure you watch the video after this one, because I have some stuff planned for the weekend. Bye.